Hello, hello, my name's Kaiser Anani, and I am the 1 millionth viewer of this website. With me here today is Randy.
Hello.
And Ocelot.
Yep, I'm right here where you want me.
So, as usual, this is all picks, so we just get to start with the general lineups. Sadly, only one decent.
Crystal Maiden.
Everybody gets it.
Yeah, sure. Trying. So, team comps, first things first, right? Dire is severely overcarried. The only person they have that's even like a support is VS, and she's still better off pause for. She's not a hero that can really easily get away with just, you know, wards and a mech, you know?
And, you know, Morana 2 years ago.
Yeah, if you want to play Morana support, I guess you could, but for some reason I doubt that's happening. Radiant actually has a pretty balanced lineup, a little over-mitted though. But, you know, OD or Morphling can both act, honestly, as safe lane carry. I guess the ideal way to do it would be have Morphin safe, Pudge at mid, OD at top, maybe with Centaur.
30 seconds to showtime.
Then have, Skyrat that bot with Morphling. I think that'd be a pretty solid lane lineup. Again, kind of dual carries at top, but what are you going to do about it? It's better than dual carries in every lane.
Yeah.
Except for the one VS. God, what if she goes mid?
Oh, please.
Everyone's chasing Faceless Void up here for some reason. No, they just wanted to put down a sentry here for some reason? Okay.
And they're off.
Alright.
Because I imagine anybody's going to be using this camp up here. Jolene.
Got a feeling this is going to be good.
I don't know what that means, sir.
The only other thing I could think of is that they wanted it to ward it, but like, for one, it just got to ward
it itself.
Does
that block a camp? Oh, I guess not anymore.
And on top of that, even if they did, they know there's no supports up that way. They saw VS on top, so...
Is Void jungling?
I hope not.
Check his items. Does he have an Iron Talon?
Oh my
god. He does.
God. Yeah, he does.
Jungle Void.
Don't do that.
I think they blocked
no,
his... I think they... I was gonna say, I think they blocked his camp, though, because they plonked a sentry for, like, no reason up there. Yeah,
no,
they did block it.
Like, they... Okay, so Radiant plonked a sentry, like, right here, and then Void just was like, I'll get rid of that by putting another one that'll block my own sentry. And now Pudge is just, like, up here to stare at it. What the fuck?
What do I do? What the hell is that thing?
Throw a hook at it!
He's Radiant, by the way. What's he doing here?
Hook someone.
Oi, hook the tower!
Void. Oh no, don't tell me he gets stuck. Oh no!
God.
Oh, okay, it's okay.
Deep.
Bye.
What the hell is he doing?
What was that?
That was a weird exchange. So,
I guess he didn't want to get hooked, but man, that's the most just scared man I've ever seen. Did he go top? Where's Void? Did he go back to spawn?
Void went back to a bot lane, but now he wants to jungle. Void, it's not gonna happen. These guys are not spawning in. I'm sorry, you blocked yourself, you idiot. Pudge is just kinda here.
I like Morphling's branch party. It's good.
Okay, now that's an effective build if I've ever seen one.
It actually really is, because he has effectively about, what, 12 tangos, because he gets the doubled health, or at least the duration, for eating a iron branch tree.
Yeah, but you know what would be better than that is...
Someone's blood was drawn out of dark.
Missing first blood.
Yep. Missing first blood, he just got sunstruck down. That did not look very impressive. Yeah, he just got forged into a sunstrike, so he did not miss a lot. So that's 1k.
He probably also got cold snapped into it. That's a lot of damage in the early game, to be fair.
And an assist from Morana somehow, even though she's nowhere near here.
Must have just thrown an arrow, I guess.
Yeah, probably hit an arrow.
So, as I was saying, yeah, Morphling, you know, the branches are cool and all, but you could also get an enchanted mango, which not only gives you, and he's not even using the branches for that, which not only gives you an additional point of HP regen, and Void calls GG, or like, is that's funny, you also get...
Because he wants to do ancient games.
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
And look, the creep
spawned. Up, jungle. The enemy jungle. Look at the top.
How to stay that fucking late. Yeah, nothing's happening here, this is just a bull.
It doesn't mean anything. What does it mean?
Never play hard lane.
Oh. Yeah, not as Void anymore, particularly.
I mean,
ease it off later now.
I mean, you can. You can do it really easily, just not solo. Yeah. There are a lot of people who are good at offlane, not solo.
Oh, that's a dead invoker.
God, please. Boom.
And of
Rip.
Course, Odie wants to steal the kill, like, really, really bad.
And he can pretty easily, you know.
That was a lot of investment just to get invoker, too. Luckily, Void has no idea how to play his lane, so it's not like it matters, and,
Negate
you know,
that first blood gold.
It just hit me that we're tri-laning top, and one of the people in our tri-lane is playing as a carry. That's
good. Yeah. Good.
That's good. That's what I like to see.
As I was saying earlier, Void doesn't really conform to any rules right now. He's just kind of a walking ult.
Yeah, he just kind
of
is.
He's more of a core in that case. He just sort of has these abilities to supplement a team fight, but he doesn't really contribute to many of the kills that go on.
Rana,
I mean, sure, Chrono can lead to some carry power, but he just doesn't really fit into a specific niche unless he has heroes like, say, Jakiro, Darkseer, yada yada on his team. People who need time to get their damage out.
I had to guess Void just got,
He just got silenced by Skyrath, who's putting a bunch of points into
silence Waveform, yeah.
I'm noticing this is gonna be a hell of a match to cast because these people are just going full to death in no time. Pudge.
Oh,
you better be careful. Oh my god!
Oh boy.
Holy shit, that was a. Uh oh. Well.
Oh!
Sweat, and the stain is gone.
Oh god, that poor Pudge.
That was unfortunate.
Say he should have seen that coming, but I'm guessing that, you know, it's funny, but whenever you see Invoker in his weird, like, shove thing where he goes, like, with his hands, that means he's casting a spell in that direction. If you see him doing that, you're either about to be Sunstruck or you better call it out.
This is lethal.
Oh,
lethal.
This Invoker is on point with his Sunstrikes, but it's not going to be enough because this Mirana is going to die again. She does not have her lethal.
Oh,
God,
no,
a point blank arrow.
Wasted all of her mana on it, so now she dies like a chump.
It's not a million patches.
Are we gonna see another Sunstrike here? Are we gonna see another Sunstrike?
I don't think so. It's gotta be on cool. Oh, wait, no?
Oh, boy.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy.
Yep. He knows.
Yeah, this time he's too smart for it. So
he's been daggered. He's been daggered, though. There's no way he'll know if he's getting Sunstruck in the right spot or not. Man, he is paranoid. Watch, this is going to be one of those clips where he tries to run all the way back to spawn, being as dodgy as possible. He gets right up to the lip of the fountain and just gets blasted.
I'm going to keep a quick eye on Invoker here just to see if he actually does it.
Is Void still trying to kill that camp in there?
Yeah.
What is his level? He's level 3! He's already out of tangos! My god!
He is tied for the lowest level in this game currently with VS. Apparently this Void hasn't realized that you can get XP from creeps without directly beating them up, so he's just like running way away from the lane and trying to like jungle pointlessly. Now he's not going to die because Morphling has not even put a single value point into either his ult or his W. Because you can really get away with pure right click Morphling early game.
Is he going Fatling? I think he's going Fatling.
Might be Lincoln's.
Yeah,
it's
probably Lincoln's.
I
was worried.
It was a Lotus Sword.
Yeah, I was worried for a second that he might be building, like, a Battle Fury, which would be
Battle
awful.
Fury, yeah. Battle Fury Morphling.
Pudge shows up to do nothing except get arrowed.
A very short range arrow, so he's just gonna. Oh,
it might
strike.
Now.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Pudge,
please kill yourself, my man.
Nope, he's gonna get away. Oh,
nope.
Well, that was unfortunate. Oh my god. Skyrath better count his blessings there, because he just. Only his, insistence.
Oh god.
Well, I was going to say, only his insistence on going back in the lane.
Good
there,
lord.
But, yeah, this is a bloodbath. This is a bloodbath and a half.
There's more kills than there are minutes collectively in the game.
There's more kills on Radiant than there are minutes in the game. Okay, exactly as much.
She
did not calculate the distance on her leap just well enough. She got bounced back off the cliff, BS dying immediately.
And now what I said is true. Invoker is smart enough to body block himself off with that Forge Spear, and he knows the Fat Man's on his trail. And
he should not stick
really
around.
Immobile this game.
Void is still level 4.
This void is just making me sad.
Listen, I understand why you would feasibly want to do this, right? But if you're going to jungle, just go full on in jungle. Trying to do this in one camp is not a good idea.
Jesus Christ.
That, my friend, is the power of the Exhort Invoker build.
That's the power
that
of
is
Oxyclave.
Very. Yeah. It gets rid of stains.
Fast.
God.
Fast.
Speaking of a stain, there's about to be a bloody smear in this mid lane. I can just feel there's a kill waiting to happen. I can tell that BS is just waiting to ult that guy. Top. Just a glimpse at top.
Comes Pudge.
Oh,
he sees BS.
Top, yeah.
They do
what
not
are these wards?
Have sight on that Pudge.
What are these wards? Okay.
Fuck.
Sure, yeah.
I don't think that even blocks it.
No.
This centaur really likes the concept of dying. This VS could literally just swap someone in and just instant arrow, dead.
So quick look. Can't ever have too many of these.
Casual raindrops, you don't see those.
Honestly, if I were looking at it, he's probably building a veil, if I had to say. It's a very common item these days. It's a low-income item, and it's very easy to make good armor, good everything.
Yeah,
so I'd say that right now.
We got a lot of casual raindrops going on, even though, mostly on the rating, even though there's only two forces of magic damage on the Dire, only one's worth worrying about.
No, there's a lot of magic sources on the Dire.
The issue is that a lot of them are magic forces that either raindrops aren't going to be enough for, or raindrops are too much for. It's just like, at that point, just get a cloak, man. If you really want it that bad.
Oh boy.
Yeah, get
it. Oh, the hook. He's looking for it. He wants it. He's not gonna go for it, though. Pudge, you have to execute, man.
They know he's there. Oh, he's gonna get arrowed, isn't he? Yeah.
Oh, God.
Marauder.
Damage control.
Oh, God.
Centaur is not gonna succeed at damage control.
Spectre's gonna get him. Vector, don't back away. You're a way stronger than these guys. Good lord.
Hit R, man. This is what your ult was born to do, Spectre. Come on. There we go. Stomped. Centaur kills himself.
Centaur kills Spectre.
Unfortunately, these guys waited way too long to dive that tower. They should have had him right then and there, but they waited way too long. I mean, they paid for it.
Yep.
Guess what's
hesitation is probably the most lethal thing in Dota.
How many times
you
do you think
your
we're
teammates.
Going to say that over the series of these casts? Uh-oh.
Not nearly enough. If there's one lesson I'd like to leave as an impression upon the rest of the Dota community, it is that you should not hesitate. Patience and hesitation are two very different things.
Void does not have so much time, so I don't...
No.
It's not gonna matter.
Invoker is churning out some ludicrous amounts of damage. I'd say that this is a good blade mail game. They have lots of just hard damage focus, but...
Yeah.
They
lots
have a lot of very
focus.
Tanky people on their team.
Lots of high damage on the Dire business. That they really can't avoid dishing out. So it'd be really easy to, you know, trap Invoker, just make him really hurt by his own meatball or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Very good blade mail game for the rating. I think very good Lotus Orb game as well. Just being able to reverse, you know, the stuns, the swaps. All the things Invoker can do will be very good here. Because that's the big gimmick Dire has right now. It's not necessarily their magic damage, but their...
Scanned.
This is an interesting place to meet up.
Oh, does he have a for hook? No.
No, he already used it. Oh man, Morphling finally
Morphling's gotten himself a... Tower in a pretty he has a Dragonlance.
Right yep. Hurricane Pike Morphling, you know.
Interesting.
That's actually pretty devastating considering how hard he can morph his agility for raw damage as while distancing himself from the enemy. So I wouldn't give it too much merit considering that while it does give him the two stats he desperately needs, more agility and strength, I will note that his attack speed is pretty abysmal unless he actually, you know, specifically gets it. The stats he gets are nice, but it really shines when he gets something like, an Assault Kairos. Because at that point, you can just lob on auto attacks with absolute. Yeah, you can lob auto attacks from excessive range with superbly lethal damage. It's probably the most powerful right click in the game.
Invoker is
just without
demolishing
any bonus
mid.
Attack. Speaking of demolishing, Just... Good body blocks, but Pudge is way too fast!
Yeah.
Oh my god!
Oh my no. god! I just want to mention that, before that fight, Void finally picked up...
Invoker might buy back to get that Skywrath.
Void finally picked up the first part of his legs at 13
Oh,
minutes.
Centaur! Oh, baby! Oh.
Rip.
Absolute brutality.
Mirana has already started her path to the axe.
Best do something about that.
Oh god.
Warfling's just ratting butt, and the only person who's coming to stop him is a man who maybe is able to do the least of all.
But he is a clone now. That's gonna die to the power.
Just wait till this Morphling gets an axe.
God.
Oh, that'll be great. He'll be able to throw Mirana arrows, he'll be able to do all sorts of good stuff.
Morph, what are you doing, man?
Actually, I forget. Are you able to hybrid enemies or is it just allies? I never really looked into the tooltip of things.
It's enemies.
Oh god, he nearly walked in for that.
Yeah.
I've noticed the reason Morph isn't leveling his ults is because he's really bad about microing it. If he was there, he probably could have actually gotten that tower just using the Void as the tank and himself as the damage, but he just kind of control clicked. Hell, even now he's still just control clicking. Putting it on autopilot. It's not something you can do if you want to be effective with Morph. It's not as bad as like the old days, where it would be a complete no-sell. Like, you'd just be, don't play Morph if you can't micro your illusion, but it's still something you definitely have to keep track of. So we're gearing up for a team fight here. Quick sweep of the item check. Centaur's got his flank already. I'm working on Axe. Voker doesn't really have luck because he went for an early Midas and he hasn't been able to really get a lot of use out of it because he just has not been safe to just keep going out and Midasing what he wants. So he's not... You know, he's only sitting on 1k. So that's probably going to be Arcane Boots or something, right? Going fast.
Bottom tower.
And we're going to get Void. Really going to get Void. Here comes the arrow.
Dunk. Oh boy.
Pudge is way outmatched. Oh, and a sun strike too.
God, that.
Booker's on point for.
Good job! You got
dead.
Him!
Dead! Excellent!
That Void must be feeling really stupid
Excellent.
Right now.
Excellent!
God, I can almost hear the report being sent.
The best part is it took him the entire Chronosphere and then an auto attack to actually off him.
Oh.
Centaur.
A shameful Pudge.
Centaur, wake up.
Oh god.
Oh boy, here we go.
Oh god, Centaur, no!
Pudge stops his dismember for no reason, dies for it, and does not get the kill. That's bad.
You wanna know why he's dying? Look at his items. Tranquil Boots
is like a bunch of shit. What's he building here? A Bloodstone?
Aetherlens. Okay. Aetherlens
is another one of those items that just kind of looks like it's a bunch of random shit to me, honestly.
I mean, it used to require a cloak, too, which I honestly missed, but it was just the perfect item because you could just stack them for the spell amp, the mass amounts of mana, and HP regen.
Yeah, well, there was
crap,
a time.
I actually had a game that I had a Zeus where I literally built 5 of those before they, like, changed it or it didn't require a cloak. Enemy Huskar jumped me at one point. I took like 50 damage from it. It had so much spell amp that I hit my ult and it might as well have had Axe at that point for the damage amp it gave me.
Yeah,
it was
there
bull.
Was a time where there was just no reason to build anything else on a lot of heroes.
What are you going for? Force.
Oh!
Sorry, Void. Not today.
Eventually.
You know, if Odie was really unlucky, his Raindrop would have eaten all the damage from that. Oh my god!
Pudge barely saved Warfling out there. This was not the match for a Faceless Void, I gotta say. They just have way too many stuns, silences, lockdown, and so on for him to just do anything here.
And people are just generally too tanky for him to take him on.
Who just got put in jail? I couldn't tell there. Like a creep.
I think it was a creep.
Creep, yeah.
Somebody needs to deny that tower.
I assume they're saving their glyph. Fucking free glyph or whatever.
The tower won't last much longer. Here we go.
No breaking glyph through the Dire's structures for now.
That's why they're not denying it.
Dire's mid towers have. Come on, just somebody hit it, like once, man. Are you really this scared by all these B-listers?
My invoker will murder you. Or we'll get murdered, and okay.
Well, sorry, Void. Not today. Yeah. Oh my god. Now that was a perfect time for an ODL. Come on, man, you gotta drop this. Come on, man, you cannot hesitate with an ult like that.
Yeah, Veil ult, man. What the fuck?
Even without the Veil, I think it still would have been fine to just straight drop the ult. I mean, it's level 2 already. He's pretty high level at this point in the game.
But I will Veil the creeps. You know, because that's good.
Morling was riding top that whole time, by the way. Guys, why, VS, why did you stun an illusion of yourself? What were you thinking?
Get rid of that useful replicate.
That's the way to do it. Yeah, don't let Morph TPE back in on that and get himself killed. Don't let Skywrath Mage, I think that is. Yeah, circle the map for no reason. Don't scan the rune even though you know nobody's there because you have the sentry and you're standing there, you fat idiot. What a useless scan. Honest to God. Oh my god!
Oh, from downtown.
Oh, that's unfortunate. That's bad. And that's why you build the damn Aether Lens on Punch, man.
Yep.
You thought I was exaggerating when I sent 78 times at one match to build Aether Lens on Punch. There's your distinct.
I'm just gonna say this right now. Inspector ults and Morana flies in and hits her Q. That could be Rampage territory right there. But Spectre does not have her ult, actually. Damn.
Yep, ult arrow.
Probably the worst person to get it with that arrow in there. So that's unfortunate.
And Morph can now live twice. Sadly, he still doesn't really have any items of note. He's kind of doing that classic thing that I don't like people doing, where he's got, like, there are two big ways, well, I guess three big ways to build Morphling, right? He's just, like, taking the Dragonlance from one side and the Blinkens from another, and it's just, like, they're not really gelling together. He needs more items. Like, he needed something else before that Dragonlance, and he needed something else before that Blinkens, you know?
Boy, touch me!
Beats fresh.
A very dead boy. Life
is Jesus, this Pudge is going at it. I'm gonna say that much. They get some real good hooks for this game, especially for something that seems to be higher than average skill level.
Oh boy.
Vector's holding 4-0 game. He just dies like a chump.
Centaur nearly died too. He was near spawn when it happened.
That can be disjointed? By Leap? Okay.
Apparently so.
Leap can destroy almost any projectile in the game. The only one I think it can't disjoint is Lich's ult.
Morphling Scorn does not go after Spectre, even though he probably should have. Pudge hooks literally nothing for no reason. Invoker gets Pung. Okay. Yeah, that's a good place to be. Just, right here in the jungle. Thank you for circling that, Skywrath Mage, or else I wouldn't have known the jungle was in this game. Spectre is still farming up. For somebody who's been doing pretty good for, especially assist, she does not have a lot of items. I don't know what she's going for, but she's...
Manta, I guess.
It's not... If you're gonna get Manta, you get fucking Diffblade first, man!
Am I the only one that thinks that there needs to be more for Yasha to build into than just Sanji, Yasha, and Manta?
Yeah.
I mean, we got, like, for a while we had, like, Silver's Edge and...
I was going to say, unpopular opinion, but I would not mind a return to Silver's Edge being built with Sanj. I actually like that a lot more than the old orb build, mostly because it goes well with all the heroes that I regularly play, but you know, I'm unbiased, so. Here we go. Centaur Warrunner, kind of caught him in here, tries to initiate, but they are way too prepared, and both teams just kind of back off.
You can tell that he was literally skirting the distance between VS's ult right there. She was ready to swap his ass in and get him killed.
Looks like
getting killed. How much you want to bet they're going to jump? How much you want to How much you want to bet they're gonna jump this pudge?
Yeah, I'm following.
Like
this.
Full force.
God.
Come on.
Arrow.
Throw the arrow. Nobody finishes a hurricane pike. Run a vanquish. Oh my God!
Oh
my
Lord! Jesus!
They saw through the illusion. Burn
one, two. Oh, he's out of it. It's your old man.
Is he gonna be able to get this DS? He has Aegis still, doesn't he?
Yep.
Oh, it's not gonna be enough though. He's just
not
way out
trying to go for it.
Yep.
Does he still have that Pudge illusion? He better teleport to it now.
Nope, it's gone.
Oh Lord!
Barely gets out of there. It looks like, but
I don't think he's gonna be able to escape this. One of them's gonna die for it. They have way too much chase down.
Oh my God!
Yeah. Unless they just let it get away from them. My God.
Yep, they kind of turned tail there. They were five to the three living Radiant members, and they still kind of just stopped. I don't know what that was about exactly.
This morphling better hope Invoker doesn't randomly sunstrike the fountain, because he's morphing full agi for a bit there.
Up. I was about to say, is that Mariana Ags? It sure is. So
speaking of Aghanims, is there any sign of VS Aghanims?
VS no. Ags, it's a no.
Spirits, you know, that's really sad. Like, it's so strange, because of all people to get, like, a screw death ability. Not a lot of heroes get that. I mean, we got Wraith King, we kind of got Terrorblade in that way, where he can siphon life off of someone else and bring himself back to full. Got kind of Huskar, Abaddon. There's a handful of heroes who have that kind of gimmick in one way or another. But of all people to have one, BS is the most unique, where, oh yeah, you straight up die, but you just become an illusion that gets all of your abilities. Sure, it takes more damage, but it gets all your abilities and effects and everything. It's just straight up just a second chance. You can still farm while you're running around with your illusion. It's just the perfect upgrade.
So Morphling is either going for a Butterfly or an E-Blade. Both of which he arguably should have got first, but both of which, I guess it's not too late, because it's only 25. So, you know, the risk that paid off this time.
And Shotgun, great.
Yep, here we go. Skywrath Mage has got basically nothing. Pudge just got his Aether Lens building up a Blade Mail. OD finishes Hurricane Pike, which could be big if he, could be bigger if he used his ult ever, but I don't think he's used it yet. Centaur Warrunner kind of has like 6.79 Centaur items.
What's with all the scribbling?
Yeah.
What's with all the scribbling? Rana, we're going to go for a Smoke Ache here that is probably honestly not going to amount to anything.
My waters rise.
Oh boy.
Oh, Skywrath dropped like a million centuries. Oh, they're gonna die for this.
Here comes the counter initiate.
Oh, here comes the punishment for their crimes. Boy, he drops a fruitless chrono. Not even gonna get him. Not even gonna get him. Oh, he got Urn, he's gonna die! Oh. Meatball City.
Christ, that was a lethal fight.
Morphling is the last to survive, and
he might
be out
still
of here.
Die.
Come on, Mirana.
What is he doing?
No fear, Mirana. What the fuck? What are you people doing?
He's shotgun Morphling. You're scared of him.
Yep.
Oh, close on that Sunstrike, but no cigar.
Come on.
Shotgun Morphling, you know, no mana.
Shotgun Morphling.
Oh.
1v1 is great. Shaka Morphling with three people in the neighborhood. Uh-oh.
With no mana.
Oh, he's got mana. Oh, Sonny, you messed up.
Guys,
you better morph strength and TP out. You better morph strength and TP out.
The
deadest man.
Shotgun.
Guys.
Get him.
Just kill the man.
Fear is right! Fear is right! How
fear?
Much of
is that actually
cowards
fear?
Are you? Probably not. Fear is fucking right! They took 6 hours to actually try and go in on the helpless Morphling, and by the time they did, it was too late.
If you guys ever had that moment growing up as kids where you would go to the river with your friends, you'd jump off of something, go swimming, and like you always have that one guy you brought along who's not typically a fearful full person of heights. But he just sits there at like this meek jump, and it's just like, that guy who just hesitates on everything. It drives you bonkers. Just like, just jump already. You're holding up a line. Ooh. That's this team. A group of
Oh
God.
Well, it's time for more flair. Time for.
Oh
God, Bayless White just got stomped.
Oh, it's just bones.
GG. What the fuck do you mean, GG? It's 21 to 27, and you're not funny.
Okay. I thought they were really gonna go for that punch there.
More flank. Okay.
It's okay. Spectre just left.
Hey, Spectre got that item that she needed before Manta. Did she get it before Manta? Of course not.
God.
She gonna have a TP scroll? Of course not. She really needs that magic wand at 28 minutes. With 1700 down. Oh, she's smart.
Oh, she's holding it. There we go.
Wow.
There we go.
Color me surprised.
Speaking of TP scrolls, is this Pudge even carry anymore? No.
No.
Might have had slots for it, but I think he's been toting wards.
Pudge just remembers the jungle crate live on stage. Just split some mug golems. Okay.
Still has a mango.
Eat the mug golems, man. Come on.
Invoker has a link in
his
recipe. Honestly,
you're
unradiant.
So close to the orb.
Dire's mid tower use a little help.
Unradiant for sure to be the Lincoln's party. They can get three Lincolns or so. That VS is just going to be effectively out of the game. So, in this moment of downtime. XP currently favors the Dire, though it's very, very up and down sort of game.
It's a roller coaster ride.
It's for gold, same story, basically. Uh-oh. What are we doing? We're just trying to get away from a gank down here. Oh, okay.
Time is money.
Skywrath Mage still doesn't have a fucking thing, and he's building Yul's first for reasons I don't understand. Morphling shotgun, and he's going to probably Manta, which is good because you don't get that when you're going shotgun. Pudge, just kind of generic items. OD, just kind of generic items, but has not really improved at all in the last couple of minutes. We are vanishing. Oh, we're going to get top, I guess.
You're frontoing too. Oh, God.
Okay.
Fourth boy.
Now this time. Kill the man!
There we go.
See, that's what happens when you actually attack your enemies, guys. Maybe do that next time, too. Morana's got a blank dagger. Okay. I mean, she already kind of has that, but better. If you want to get that, you might as well build, like, Force or something. Pudge just remembers the jungle creep again. Fresh main. Invoker still hasn't really built much. He's gotten a axe, and he's working on Lincoln, but beyond that, he's still kind of, on the down low. Also, she's shelving parts of his Lincolns to carry around that Basilius for some reason. Even when he gets it, at least he has travel.
Radiant's mid tower's getting banged up.
Spectre's fine. BS, I guess, is fine. And boy, it's pretty unfortunate. Well, oh, that's unfortunate. That is really unfortunate.
Oh,
uh-oh. Pudge is crazy, man!
Pudge's out for blood!
Oh, shit! Pudge got the suicide and Invoker goes down.
Yep, that's bad.
You wanna know what else is really sad about this game? I just like to point something out here.
What's
that, Chief? Let's go ahead and go over to the current levels that went in the game.
One second before we do that. Oh
yeah,
my god.
This fight is still going on. Centaur dies. Morphling's got a
Spectre Illusion fight! Oh, rip. Rana just walking around at like no HP. But nobody can do anything about it, so like it matters.
GG, because I'm funny.
Game! I'm funny, guys! I'm really cool and funny. Please like my YouTube channel. It's www.beetlegoose.com.
Oh.
Hey, look at our levels real quick. Pudge is 12 somehow. He's the lowest in the game. What the hell?
Like I said,
roaming around.
He's been roaming around, though, getting kills, though. Yeah. And he's had books, and you know, that's surprising. I did not expect him to be that low level.
Like I said, it's just a surprisingly low level that just... I looked at it, was like, no way. But,
wait,
yeah.
Hold on, is Void Building Axe?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Honestly, it's pretty good considering the team he has with, you know, Invoker's Meatball and Starkhall and... Jeez, just about everything they have, really. It would have been better if they had Skywrath on the Void team, because then he could just murder the hell out of people, which could actually stab him in the ass if you really didn't pay attention.
The issue with Void in this lineup, though, is that none of the things that go very well into with his ult are things that are going to last in the late game, and as Void now, you need that. You cannot subsist on yourself alone. He just isn't powerful enough for that.
Yeah.
What he needed here was something like Death Ward, especially if he was going to go into an Axe, which is a big burden. Especially before any sort of real attack item. What he needed was a Witch Doctor, what he needed was, didn't make you know, maybe even something like a Phoenix. I don't think Sunstrike and Meatball and all that are really going to be enough to make that Axe purchase worthwhile. Maybe the 60-second cooldown on it will come into play for him, but I just don't buy it. Goodbye, Murano, Replicant. This is basically the best smoke gank I've ever seen, by the way. They just popped smoke and just went right down to bot and started bashing creeps for basically no reason. You know, it's really good to buy smoke on teams that you're not 5-stacking with.
Yeah.
Because that always ends up doing anything. Ars bull wobble bull. Yeah, you got that right. Anyone speak barbarian and know what that means?
No.
You wish, buddy.
Damn. Maybe I'll get Goofu on the line. He can cast a game with us, right?
Oh, God.
The best video we've ever had. Goofu casts the pub. Alright. Sieging the hell out of bot tier 2. Radiant lost. Oh my God! Morphling's going crazy!
Morphling
doesn't give a shit,
please.
He's not even gonna get the kill!
God, Spectre!
He's gone.
Wow.
Ooh.
Jesus, that was close. But Spectre is not finished yet. Oh, Spectre is finished, I guess. Oh, where's she at now? Oh, here.
Morphling really hates Cold Snap. Oh god, guys? Spectre's got like 5k gold saved up. She's not getting what I think she's getting.
Oh shit! Pudge barely gets knocked out of his
debut.
Ripped.
Probably going for a Radiance if I had to guess. That's a very typical item for Spectre.
Radiance.
But this point in the game, I don't have to be a grand choice for Spectre. I think honestly, against that lineup, she could really do more with like a kid in school.
Hold on, Spectre has to rage quit. XD. Now, the thing you get, as I said before, and as I say again, the main draw of using Radiance on, especially on a hero like Spectre, is the mischance. And considering that none of these people seem too apt or too willing to build an MKB, I think it's a thing worth taking, because, I mean, you get Radiance and Morphling just goes, miss. What's he going to do then? All he can do at that point is shotgun that's just one guy for his life. And even if he tries to put himself in ghost form, well, guess what, asshole? You just get burned to death by the Radiance.
You know, that's just the thing, though. I think, personally, that a better item these days for Spectre is something that gives her a decent crit chance, and honestly, it's the newest addition to the crit family. It's a Bloodthorn. Most heroes benefit from it, but it's the fact that it gives True Strike on your target that guarantee crits, and you can also pile up all your illusions on one person, just start absolutely mauling someone.
It'd be alright for
have
a...
damage on yes.
It'd be alright for an item to replace the Urn of Shadows when it gets to that point, but I don't know about before Radiance. I mean, just the importance of making OD miss every shot he takes, the importance of making Morphling miss every shot he takes, I think Radiance kind of outweighs that. And then you can get Bloodthorn, and then that will be true sadness for both of them.
You know, speaking of guaranteed crits and illusions, another person that would really benefit these days from the consistent purchase of a oh, she's back.
Welcome
of a
back.
Bloodthorn is, of all people, all right. Phantom Lancer. Yeah. He's got all those illusions running around, and honestly, he scales off in the late game if he just sort of hits his cap. If they have an enemy with a Radiance, he just sort of loses his focus, you know, because he misses all the time, his illusions start dying fast. But the one thing that really keeps him in the game at that point is a Bloodthorn. A Bloodthorn keeps his illusions from missing. In that case, they do much, much more consistent damage. Ooh. And finally, when the effect, the silence ends, he just goes pop.
Invoker,
your target dies.
Gets his life saved. Tracking Morphling down, but nothing's gonna come of this.
Yeah, that ghost walk saved him from the most gruesome death.
Yeah.
And his,
speaking of a gruesome death, this void is a bit far in with the whole enemy team, save for Centaur.
Too, so.
My god, what is he cooking?
Void, please. Oh! Jesus Christ.
Right in the back of a garbage truck! My god!
Void Dags is on the way to him right now.
Void!
That was so devastating, I'm pretty sure Morana's not even in Dota 2 anymore.
God.
So.
I witnessed people getting metaphysically deleted, but that is. Oh no.
Meatball!
Meatball!
Fires your stupid now.
Oh, God, and Void Zags is there. This Morphling, no! Morphling, no!
Uh-oh.
Goodbye. Ripping this.
This is looking bad for the Radiant. They let Dire just do too damn good early game by, just not stressing their advantages enough and by trying to split way too much. That's one thing I noticed about Morphling. I wasn't going to call it until it ended like this, but early game, he just spent too much damn time outside of, you know, the fights. He was just like, I want to rat and get top tier 2. And yeah, sure, he got top tier 2 for it, but they lost mid bot and all their fucking people, you know?
Yep.
Shadows.
That was an interesting move on Void's part.
Yeah, didn't even have Chrono. What would happen if he got just stunlocked right there and just punch hooked into the fountain?
That would be a
Void, please.
Ooh, speaking of, oh, he's boned. Yep.
Don't time walk around like a dumbass.
Oh,
don't time walk around like a dumbass.
If that silence went down,
dumbasses. Morphling, no. Morphling, run.
Centaur,
this Invoker is really going for Sunstrikes right now, but it's not going to be able to push back the enemy team. They lost two for that. They haven't even taken one yet. They need to back off right now.
They're putting their blood, sweat, and tears into this defense.
Invoker, do not stick around there. They have sentries.
Aegis just got popped. The Aegis pop sound just happened.
Murata, oh. Is he gonna... Oh, I thought he was gonna meatball for a moment there.
No? Who the hell had the Aegis there? I didn't even...
It was Invoker.
Oh, okay.
Now I just gotta raise the question here. Who right now has the highest net worth? If I had to guess, it's probably Invoker. Or it's gotta be Spectre.
So Invoker. Morphling in second. Very close second. Correct. Wait, what? Wait, okay. Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Murana wants to maximize on the damage from her Star Call. So.
God, that's brutal.
That is not what I expected. Honestly, one Murana item that people don't think about in the meta right now is Aetherlens. It's actually really good on her. And it mostly just comes down to the fact that it's not just, you know, as Aetherlens always is, it's not just for her Star Call spam. Well, that is definitely a factor. Just the fact that it really, really hurts for. Oh, here we go.
Oh,
Morphling and Invoker just having a scuffle here.
Oh, it missed.
Spectre is coming in, but it's just in the wrong place. Dire backs off. So as I was saying before that, the entire two people must have been shitting themselves, the little thing there. Yeah, Aetherlens is really solid on Murana. Mostly also on the grounds that it makes every star punch a little bit harder, which is really devastating, not just on a specific target. If I was in this situation, I probably would have gotten it instead of this point.
Hell, you could even argue that a Veil of Discord combined right now. If she were to honestly just get ready for one to get a Veil of Discord put on top of the E-Blade, if she were to land a full distance arrow with the Aetherlens for the just an extra bit of range of 5% attack time, it doesn't seem like much, but it makes a difference once your info level gets higher. You get roughly, I think at the end of each game, most heroes get roughly 8 to about 12% bonus
doing,
magic damage just from stats alone. With Aetherlens tacked on top of it, plus the 25 raw percent from Veil of Discord.
First time BKB goes down, I believe, on...
Oh!
Hold, hurts the Dire like hell.
Aegis has been popped, I believe. Wait, does anyone even
Aegis? Aegis is long down.
Yeah.
Oh, Mirana barely destroys Morphling's D-Blade there.
Oh no.
Oh, gets popped by Volker. He is now out of mana. This could be
bad
for him.
He's still up for it. Mirana, what are you doing? Oh, Mirana, no.
Oh, adaptive.
Oh my god.
Who spoiled that shot? And now he just doesn't care.
Or
just dismembered somebody.
Spectre almost dies. Oh, is he gonna get it?
Clip just
relentless. Oh god, Centaur.
Where did he just die? Oh, he just was chasing Mirana.
I think he died. Yeah, I think he died to illusions or something. He wasn't
He desperately needs some more damn items, man.
Yeah.
I think he's building up. This could be either a Crimson or a Lotus, and either way, it's a little late.
He really hasn't focused in on an item that he's. This is an item that I said that all Centaur Warners need to build. It's just a Heart of Terrasque. Pure and simple. Synergizes with your passive, gives you a lot more HP and regen, and it's just the perfect item for Centaur, hands down. You need it.
I don't think
I can even argue it any other way.
You need it. I think the question is, though, on Centaur, is timing. It's when do I get this? This match, not first. This match, definitely not first. But I would not have taken a pipe. I don't think at all this game. Honestly, if I were Centaur here, I might have even gone for a glimmer over this. It's just... Like, as I said before, the issue on the Dire, well, now it's kind of evolved. The issue on the Dire is now there's just too much magic damage for the pipe to really deal with. It's not going to be a solid investment. Glimmer Cape could just, you know, ruin all that Mirana damage. You know, it could ruin that Sunstrike, so on. Pipe is just gonna, bring right through the shield. Could have even gone BKB. I think that would have been an acceptable choice, this match over Pipe. But I think I would have taken Glimmer Cape overall. Still, it's just late. Well, this is not a worthwhile target to drop a solo chrono on. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Centaur might get away with this.
Nope.
Just barely. Honestly, actually, I was wrong. You know what he needs more than a Heart of Terrasque right now? Hands down. Oh, this Pudge.
Spectre gets destroyed. Pudge falls in his tracks.
Skywrath follows suit. Oh,
Rips.
Oh, Morphling showed up. Oh, Lord, and there's the meatball.
Oh, this is a...
A hell of a fight.
Yeah.
Bloody. Poker. Oh, you're in trouble, my man. Oh, they line up for a second, so he's able to get a good tornado.
Is he
going to
meatball again? Nope. He's definitely going to hit Sonic Boom and fight him back.
Oh, gosh. Oh,
the E-Blade doing its work.
Barely avoids the sweet release of death. Warfling's trying to TP, but no! No dice.
The traitorous Centaur! The traitorous Centaur stunned him! Oh god, he's barely getting away!
Here he goes.
Wow.
Still going. E-Blade for E-Blade.
E-Blade twice!
And dead! And dead.
That is a full team wipe. Centaur's about to be back up, and Warfling's dead for nearly two consecutive minutes.
Yeah, because he bought
absolutely.
Back last time.
Absolutely high stakes chase right there. I haven't seen a chase that intense in a long time. I mean, good lord. You see police chases on the news, but good god, that just took a spot
Invoker,
for itself.
Use your goddamn... Listen, it doesn't matter if the fucking Forge here at Simon, just make them right-click the racks. Holy shit, this is some poor micro and it's poor use of his long open time. Just get the racks, man. Just get the racks. Just wait for the next wave. Get the racks.
Centaur
double edges him. Get the racks. Where are you going? Take your... Here. Let me do it for you, okay? Okay. Select these. Here's what you do. You right click. Come on, man. Look how close they are to dead. They're half dead. Man,
if he sticks around any longer, he's gonna get like blink hooked by Pudge or something.
His racks are half dead. Just micro. Just, it's not hard. It's
time
just,
is money.
Okay. You know what? It's fine. We don't need racks. Dire does not need any rags. You know, we should not...
Don't use a giant
amount of time you got, morphling free. Why would you do that when you can just farm?
Now, speaking of giant amounts of something, I'd like to point something out. Invoker has, like, almost 9k golds just hoarded up, and he still has Midas when he's level 25. I hope to God he's not getting Rapier, because if he gets screwed, that Rapier is going to someone infinitely worse than anyone on the entire Dire team could potentially...
Nobody
take
cares!
Aegis!
Guys!
No!
Guys! Dang it! Drop! Fucking cheese! Okay.
What's Spectre drop? What did you drop? Okay, the urn.
That was about 80 seconds of the...
Oh my god!
Ground that Morphling
okay.
Can
look at all that
waveformed in there.
Okay, seriously, I think I lost track of this earlier, but if there's something that Centaur needs to get this game, it's an Ags. A lot of these guys are escaping by leaping over walls or through trees, so... Yeah. They really, really need that. Speaking of stuff they need right now, this guy needs to get a clue, because he's screwed!
RIP.
Oh my god!
Centaur just fights it!
Oh, they're going for kills instead of the Rex. No!
Here comes the
crumb. Oh, not the meatball!
Meatball!
Waiting.
Meatball
into it!
Holy shit!
Ding, ding, ding! Flyback's like hell. Meat's fresh. There goes
Invoker. Invoker's down.
Spectre's backing up. Invoker's butt back!
Oh my
god!
1 HP!
Here it comes, here it comes! Oh.
Circuit saves a life!
That
goddamn... Oh, he really wants this kill!
He's down for one! He's gonna get it.
Holy shit!
Wow! Oh. Mirana didn't even get a chance to eat her cheese back there.
Yeah, she just went from full to nothing in a second flag, because she tried to fucking go around the racks to go for kills, which was a poor idea. This point of the game, poor idea.
This match is absolutely intense. It's a bit... It's a bit rocky in a couple areas, but when these fights start breaking out, it is just a symphony of murder.
Yeah, this is hell. This is like war is hell, man. Look at this! Look at this!
Oh my god! 200,000!
But Morphling is now the highest on the net worth chart after the death of Invoker.
Alright, humor me real quick. What? Speaking of Invoker, what is he sitting on for gold? He still has a shitload of gold!
Yep,
he got a refresher, he still has 4,000! My god!
He got a refresher
and
butt back, and he still has 4k. This is the richest man. It's time! Okay, he did sell his money. It's time to sell the drum.
Small loan of 1 million Dota gold.
It's time to sell the drums. Skyrath Mage has dead.
RIP.
Okay, in all honesty, if Invoker's gonna be helping his team push in, it's a bit of a risky thing to lose the stat bonus coming off of his...
Oh boy.
But he could do one of two things right now that would benefit his team greatly. He could build either an assault hero...
Oh, no! Punch!
Punch got him!
Like I
punch
said, though.
Punch was trying to go for Skyrath. Punch.
Yeah, this is still going!
Oh, meatball!
Punch eats it.
Top Rex.
Whoa, I did not notice that.
Morphling take those
mics?
Morphling got
him,
that was fast.
Solo rat.
What are his items? That was really fast, even for Morphling.
It's time for Dire to turn around, go by, and get that rack just to match.
Oh yeah,
this is not
definitely. Absolutely.
Right-clicking top is not a fruitful endeavor. And it looks like they're doing so.
Boy, get Morphling. Travels.
Morphling, my god, man, get out of there.
Oh my god, Volker just got destroyed.
And he's dead for over 2 minutes. That
it's
is not good.
33 to 51. The 51 dudes are just getting crit stomped now. I've got to see what happened. Surely it was something item related, right? No. No, nothing really happened as far as I know.
It's getting like
Pudge still has strengths. Pudge still has strengths for the record.
That's good. I think it's just that they keep just soloing into Morphling because they're not organized enough. Like Spectre and Invoker still want to just casually right-click for. I mean, look at this. Still just want to waste their time casually right-click farming instead of actually doing something conductive to the game. And most of these guys are just too scared to do anything. Like, look, easy opportunity to, you know, get a kill here. No.
Wow!
That got them in human reaction speed.
I really like how Centaur just walked into the Chronosphere anyway.
Oh boy, bad decision.
This man has a BKB!
Thanks for me.
And the Dire, you know, I've said before that there are times in the world where you just don't want to fall for your enemy's mistakes, but, oh God, sometimes it's just like, you have to try and save your friends.
Spectre, quick trigger finger on the flyback by Marana.
Oh, wow, does he have a Scotty? Does Morphling have a Scotty?
Yes, I have Scotty.
God, he's bad. Lord,
the most stat-rich Morphling I've seen. Oh, no.
Oh, these are five. Marana just is not able to do enough damage anymore. I think this one might be over.
Boy calls GG, except this time he's probably serious.
And he buys the Lincolns because as we all know, Faceless Void really needs defensive items.
Yeah. Oh, especially in a game like this.
Oh,
Chrono on three.
Here comes the Sky Rattle. Calling it. Here it comes.
Yep. Goes down. Void is smart enough to get out of the way, but by doing so, basically forfeits its only possible kill. Spectre is about to die. Spectre is killed.
Yeah, boom.
Still has buyback. Should we turn this around? Spectre, come on. I'm not saying you should buyback, but you should buyback. There's like three people on the enemy team that are like half health.
Punch goes
Spectre.
Down.
Spectre,
Joker
please.
Two.
Oh, buyback.
A little late.
Yeah.
This is an absolute slaughter fest.
Yeah, this is hell on both sides. XP charts are going back to Radiant Camp.
The river runs red in this game.
That's probably the fastest I've ever seen a Centaur Warrunner die in a straight succession of hits. Just rapid fire death.
One thing that's definitely started helping the Dire, I would imagine, is how Volkris got BKB now. More. Centaur buys back. He does not have the ult, though, so that's a dubious value. Tick, tick, tock. Watch motherfuckers drop.
Oh,
Lincoln's like, hell! That was like four Lincolns in throw on there. OD ults, but I don't think he got it.
Two BKBs on one BKB per team is popped. That was on OD, and I believe that's Invoker.
And now Dire up the back again.
Centaur now is a Lotusaur. We're not sure what that will really do for him. I mean, it might get a swap or a stun off on somebody, maybe even Eblade or a Dagon, but I don't really see what else.
Yeah, I do like that, though. Just the prospect of Marana Eblade Dagoning herself is really big. And it basically completely nullifies her and removes her from the game. Because, I mean, if you get Lotus Dagon on your... Like, if you are Marana, you get Lotus Dagon, it's over. You know, it's just... There's just nothing more for you to do with it. Needs a pop, though.
Meatball!
Where is it, my man? Oh, he apparently already used it. Spectre's here to just ruin Centaur's life. Probably one cent on the pain.
Invoker's gonna drop some real pan blink skies. Oh my god, Centaur, no! Centaur blink, you have a blink dagger, blink! Oh!
Barely made it out of there.
Oh. He might still get sunstruck for his troubles.
Odie's going down. Centaur TP's out. Oh, Marana just dies.
Invoker sunstrike. It's almost a cooldown, but he swings up for Ghost Walk. Come on, you can make it! Oh!
Spectre,
that is massive
shit.
Damage.
Void calls GG again, because that's really funny!
Oh boy!
Voker's on the run! God. Oh man!
Yes! Sacrifice yourself to save Invoker!
Oh god, two people are down for 100 plus on the Dire. That is bad.
Come on, hit that refresher and blow them up! Drop that meatball, yeah!
Shitty meatball.
My god! This Invoker is trying his ass off here! Here comes a tornado.
Yeah.
Oh no!
Unfortunately.
Oh boy.
Boom.
Uh-oh.
It's Sunday.
Oh.
Sadly, Bruno. Invoker accidentally walked into the Chrono, but Lotus Orb down on Morphling. They can't do anything to
the
him.
The creeps
for a bit.
Off the Ancient.
Centaur is determined to keep attacking the Ancient. Oh, the Ancient.
It's regening.
It's not enough though. He's getting repelled.
Oh my god, he just got annihilated.
Oh, and Invoker took a lot of damage from those attacks.
Invoker,
he's not going to be able to fight this back. And...
Meatball! Oh, it misses everybody.
Invoker's out. Invoker's out. It's over. Oh no.
No, he's still got some fight.
Nope.
Flesh meat, it's done! That's the game! Boom!
Holy shit!
Holy shit! We forgot to look at the statues!
Oh, fuck, man.
Oh my god, what an absolutely high-octane match.
Yeah, that was fucking... Oh my god.
Game started off a bit slow and questionable at that, but then it just turned into this absolute murder house.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. You know, a lot of people smack-talk Russians, but Russian high-level matches might be some of the most entertaining Dota games to watch. They're just insane bloodbaths.
Oh yeah.
Speaking of an insane bloodbath, this Invoker, I've got to give my personal recommendation of seal of approval to this Invoker's play. This guy is trying as hard as he could, but he just could not get that going.
Part of the issue is, ironically, the Dire was overcarried this game, but their biggest issue is that they didn't act like it. Mirana and Faceless Void both went with very early game centric sort of builds, and VS was just forced to completely be straight ward bitch, which prevented her from getting really any item of value. Only a Glimmer Cape, which never really came into play, and a Solar Crest, which she used for taking out Roche.
Yeah, lowest GPM by a lot.
Very unfortunate position to be in. Definitely, since this was, I believe, a pick game, let's find out. Yeah, this was a pick game. She really should have thought about another hero. I mean, if she really wanted...
Harder support, definitely.
Yeah, if she really wanted to have just, like, the damage bonuses, Elder Titan would not have been a bad pick here, I don't think, for that team lineup. Just, that would go with Void a lot better and make his, make that axe worth actually purchasing, honestly. Go with Mirana better for, the Lord Magic defense and all. A good hero for this lineup. I don't think Ventrue really was. I can see why she did it as well. That was supposed to go with Spectre and get some easy pickoffs, but it just wasn't enough. Still, I have no real complaints about any player in this game. The closest I can say is that Spectre and Void oftentimes were pretty hesitant to do a lot
they
of things. They
spent too much time floundering around before and even during fights.
Yeah. But to make up for it, OD was also really, really hesitant on using his ult, especially at level 1, which could have made this, 43-56 game a lot closer as far as KDA, because there were several opportunities early game that he had to just drop that ult right onto somebody, just slam the enemy team lineup, just didn't do it. Couldn't tell you why, he just didn't do it. So, I don't really have any one-sentence summaries, because there's nothing I could really say about this game in under 3 paragraphs. Closing comments, Randy?
Behold the meatball.
Ocelot?
If I have one closing comment to say on this, aside from the Player of the Game award, Sad Clown of the Game has to definitely go to Void, whose complete early game strategy of trying to go for that side ancient camp just got completely boned by himself and then by the enemy, nonetheless.
Yeah, it was not a good early game for Void. To be fair, that is one thing I guess I can't complain about, is that Void's early game was just awful. I don't know what he was thinking. Trying to, like, be a side jungler in the damn secret shop when he couldn't even take, like, most of the hard camps, let alone ancients, without backing off. That was not a very good idea. And it's probably a good reason why the early game was pretty rocky for the Dire. So, with that being said, see you next time. Maybe next time it'll be just a little less sterling than this.